Hi everybody, my name is Rupa, working as assistant professor in Chebrol Engineering College. I'm dealing the subject electrical machines 2 for second year triple students, R19 batch, JNTV Kakinada. And today's topic is construction of circuit diagram and problems, lecture 9. So up to now we have seen the various points, various losses and regarding the circuit diagram, regarding the circuit diagram. So now we will all formulate the various formulas in one page. And from the relations, what we have seen below, we can write motor input is equal to root 3 VLLK. LK I will show you. So, regarding this circle diagram, PPT. So, this is the circle diagram. Here I will say the formulas. You see the circle diagram, I will be narrating the formulas here. So regarding the circle diagram, we are giving some formulas. First one, motor input. This motor input is root 3 VLLK. This is LK. This is LK. This is the LK. Here the motor input formula will be root 3 VLLK. Okay. Next, stator copper losses. All will be multiplied with root 3 VL. Okay. Stator copper losses. What is stator copper loss here? JN. This is the stator copper loss in terms of VL, line voltage. So root 3 VL. Root 3 VL JN. Okay, this is N, this is JN. Next one, rotor copper loss. Okay, so rotor copper loss, again root 3 VL MN, this one, MN. Okay, stator loss is NJ and rotor copper loss is MN, root 3 VL MN. Next, fixed losses. Fixed losses is this one, JK, root 3 VL JK. Okay, next, mechanical output. Mechanical output is nothing but this one, ML, root 3 VL ML. Okay, next, what is the total loss? Total losses are rotor, sum of rotor loss, stator loss and fixed losses. So total M to K. So root 3 VL MK, that is the total loss. From M point to K point, that is the total loss. Next. Actually rotor output will be directly proportional to torque. So that is equal to NL. This is the rotor torque. Or rotor, sorry, rotor output. NL. Sorry, here N. This is J point, this is N point, NL. Okay, so root 3 VL NL. Next, what is the efficiency? Efficiency means output by input. What is the output? ML is the output. Okay, what is the input? LK is the input, total input. Okay, ML is the output and total line LK is the input. So what is the efficiency formula? ML by LK. Got it? ML by LK. Okay, next one. What is slip? What is the slip formula? Rotor copper loss by rotor input. What is rotor copper loss? This MN is rotor copper loss. What is the rotor input? Only input to the rotor, NL. Total input is LK. Rotor input is here, LK, NL. NL is the rotor input. So output by input, ML by LK. ML by LK, sorry, MN by NL. This is the rotor copper loss by input. Next. Next one. See here. Rotor output is ML. Rotor input is NL. So that implies it gives 1 minus S. That means N by NS. Actual speed by synchronous speed. And power factor is LK by OL. I will show you. LK by OL. LK by OL. This is the power factor cos phi. Here. Okay. OK by OL becomes sin. LK by OL becomes cos. Cos is nothing but power factor. Okay. So for drawing the circle diagram, we have to collect the following data. First one, what is that? Stator resistance test we have to conduct. We have to conduct this test for separating stator and rotor copper loss. Okay, for point E here. And second one, the two tests of induction motor. What are the two tests that are conducted to the induction motor? No load test and blocker rotor test. Blocker rotor test is also called as short circuit test. Okay, so now we will see some data in the circuit diagram. Last data, maximum quantities. We are having rarely three maximum quantities. What are the maximum quantities in this circuit diagram? Is M, point M, this is the maximum output, and point N, this is the maximum torque or maximum rotor input, and last one is point R. I will show you in next circuit diagram. One minute, please. I will show you the circuit diagram. Regarding the maximum quantities, so we are having three maximum quantities, maximum output M, and maximum torque or rotor output input N, and third one is maximum input power R. Okay, so these three are maximum quantities. Now, from the circle diagram, these maximum values occurs at the positions M, N, and R. So how they occurs, I will explain you now. First one, maximum point M. So this maximum point will be occurring at M point, where tangent is parallel to output line O dash A. Here O dash A, so A will be there. See here, this is O dash. This is O, and this is O dash. Okay, so this is O dash, this is A. So this M will be occurring where the tangent is parallel. This tangent, this line is parallel to M. Okay, this is called as tangent. This tangent line is parallel to O dash A line. Okay, so this is O dash A is nothing but output line. Okay, so how this M is located means by drawing a line CM, by drawing a line CM from C, from a point C, we have to draw a line CM from point C such that it will be perpendicular to O dash A line. Okay, so from C up to the local, up to the circumference of the circle, we have to locate M such that it is perpendicular to O dash A. Okay, so here MP, maximum output, this is vertical line, this is a maximum output line. MP is the maximum vertical output line. This is maximum point M. Next, coming to the maximum torque or rotor input, N. Okay, so this N will be occurring where tangent, this tangent is parallel to the torque line O dash E. This is the torque line. So this is this N point tangent is parallel to O dash E. M point tangent is parallel to O dash A. And the N point tangent is parallel to O dash E. Okay, so here N is also drawn from C only. So when we draw a point from C, C will be extended to N, which is perpendicular to torque line O dash E. Okay, next. The value of maximum torque is NQ. NQ is the value. This is also called as starting or pullout torque. This maximum torque is called as starting torque or pullout torque. Okay, next, last one, maximum quantities. Maximum input power, R. Okay, so this is easy to locate because it is located on the highest point of circle. Okay, so this tangent can be located which is parallel to O dash B. And it is perpendicular, proportional to RS. See here, RS, vertical line. Okay, so this is the highest point on the circle drawn. The tangent is parallel to O dash D. And R is beyond the point of maximum torque. Okay, this is always beyond maximum torque N. Always above N only, R. Okay, and maximum input, it is the, what is the maximum input means? It is the RS, nothing but maximum input level is, value is RS. It is the measure of size of circle. How the size of circle, and it is the indication of ability of the motor to carry short time overloads. Okay, so it is the indication of ability of the motor to carry how much short time in the short time, how much overload it will be carrying. This point, this RS line will be indicating. Okay, so generally this will be twice or thrice, 2 to 3 times. RS value will be 2 to 3 times than the motor input at rated loads. 2 to 3 times than the motor input at rated loads. Okay, so this is the theory part regarding the second unit also. Sorry, we are having again, circle diagram. Circle diagram theory part, this one. Still pogging, crawling, speed control is there. So regarding the circle diagram, we are having some problems. Go through them. I will say you some of the examples. Remaining, you go through them in the textbook. So first problem, a three-phase 400 volts induction motor gave the following test readings. Okay, first one, no load test. Induction motor having 400 volts, three-phase is gone through two tests, no load test and block rotor test, nothing but short circuit test. So from the no load test, we are having voltage as 400 volts, power 1250 and current 9 amperes. Again in the short circuit test, 150 volts, 4 kilowatts and 38 amperes. Okay, so by giving this data, they ask you to draw the circuit diagram. And if normal rating of the induction motor is 14.9 kilowatts, find from the circuit diagram full load value of current, power factor and slip. From the circuit diagram, we have to calculate these three. After first one is, you have to draw the circuit diagram. And from that circuit diagram, you have to find out full load value, full load value of current, next power factor and slip. Okay, first one we have to find out in the circuit diagram, we have to draw currents, right? For finding out the currents, see here. For finding out the currents, we have to draw I naught. For finding out the currents, we have to know the value of phi naught, phi s and phi 1. So if you know the angles phi naught, phi s, phi 1, we have to draw with the lagging 2E currents. Okay, lagging with V, with these phase angles, we have to draw the current values, current vectors. So phi naught, using phi naught, you will draw I naught. Using phi s, you will draw I2 dash. Using phi 1, you will draw I1. So first we have to find out the values of phi naught, phi s and phi 1. Okay, so cos phi naught, see here. From the no load test phi naught and from the short circuit test phi s. So cos phi naught is equal to power. By voltage, see here power 1250 by voltage, three phase, because we are using three phase, we have to multiply it with root three into 9. Okay, power cos phi formula, P by VI. Okay, P is 1250 from no load test and root 3 400 into 9 current. So you are getting phi naught as 78.5 degrees. Next, cos phi s from short circuit test. So power 4k, that means 4 into 10 power 3 divided by root 3 into 150 into 38. You will get phi s as 66.1. Okay, and now short circuit test. Short circuit test, from the short circuit test, we have to find out the ISN. Okay, so ISN is equal to, see here, nothing but this is the short circuit current with normal voltage. With normal voltage, what is the short circuit current we have to calculate? So ISN is equal to I into ...400 by 150. Okay, so voltage, this one, this voltage, not this voltage, no load test voltage, this main voltage, 400 by 150. Okay, as we are finding out the short circuit current, ISN formula, actually if you see in block rotor test, I gave you formulas, from those ISN is equal to IS into V by VS. Okay, so IS means short circuit current test, short circuit current, V is normal voltage, main voltage, VS is short circuit voltage. So ISN is equal to IS into V by VS. That is the formula. So V by VS means that is equal to V is 400. Vs means this one. Short circuit test voltage. Vs. Vs. You will get 101.3 amperes. Now, power taken. Power, what is the power formula? Root 3 VSL ISL cos phi S. Okay. So, if you do this, you will get 4000 into 400 by 150. From this formula also you can do 4000. Actual formula P S N is equal power taken. Total power taken is P S N into V P by sorry V by V S N. Okay. From same current formula we can calculate the power formula also same. So 4000 into 400 by 150 whole square. This becomes 28,440 watts. Okay. So see here in the figure below. This one is the figure of for our sum. For our problem, this one is the figure. So this is I naught. O dash. This is O dash point. This point is O dash. O dash is nothing but I naught. I naught will be lagging with V. Where we have to draw the I naught with 78 point. We have to draw this I naught with protractor. So from this point, 78.5 angle, you have to keep one point I naught. I naught. This line will be I naught. Okay. So this line. How to draw means I will tell 1 centimeter like that. 1 centimeter should be taken as how many values? How many values means 5 amperes. I am assuming that 1 centimeter is equal to see here. 1 centimeter is equal to 5 amperes. So for 9 amperes, we have to draw 1 centimeter and plus 3/4 centimeter. Okay, so that is the value of I naught. Suppose. See here, I am taking the scale as 1 centimeter is equal to 5 amperes, right? So, I naught is 9 amperes. Okay, no load test, I naught is 9 amperes. So, 9 amperes you have to draw on the circle diagram with an angle phi naught from V. That is 9 by 5. If you say here 1.8 centimeters I naught value you have to draw. See, this is 1.8 centimeters O dash. This is I naught 1.8 centimeters. With 1.8 centimeters in the scale, you have to draw this O naught. And from V, put an angle lagging. Lagging means back side. Leading means front side. Okay. So from back side, with an angle phi naught. Phi naught value is 78.5. So 78.5 degrees, keep a point and draw 1.8 centimeters. You will get I naught. This is I naught. Next, I2 dash. Or simply IS. From phi S, you will get I2 dash. See here, next. See, if current scale is 1 centimeter, 5 amperes, then I naught is 9 amperes. That is 1.8 centimeters. Clear? Next. Oh, this is the explanation of which I naught. And next, ISN. This is the short circuit current applied with normal voltage. So this is OA line. This is 101.3 amperes. Okay, that is 101. See here, this one. ISN, it is 101.3 amperes. So we are taking 1 centimeter is equal to 5 amperes. So 5 amperes means 1 centimeter. 103.3 amperes means how many centimeters you will get? 101.3 by 5. So 20 centimeters, 20.26 centimeters line you have to draw with an angle 66.1 degrees lagging to V. Okay, so this here from V lagging to 66.1 degrees, we have to keep the protractor from lagging. From lagging 66.1, I have to draw one line. This is the dotted line. How much you have to draw? 101.3 amperes line we have to convert it into centimeters. So 1 centimeter is equal to 5 amperes. 101.3 amperes divided by 5, it gives 20.26 centimeters. So this is I2 dash, nothing but OA line. This OA line should be 20.26 centimeters. Okay, with an angle 66.1 lagging to V. Okay, so completed. O dash OA line completed. So here you are getting locus of the circle. So see here, line here, OD. If you extend this, O dash D is perpendicular to OX. O dash D will be perpendicular to OX. Okay, now NC, we have to draw the C point. C point, how you write? If you bisect the OA, steps I have explained how you draw the circle diagram. In those steps, I have explained. If you bisect the O dash A line at the right angles, you will get the point C. Okay, so the bisected line is N. Here you will get point C. NC is right angle bisector to O dash A, right? Okay, so if you bisect the angle correctly at 90 degrees, this is the 90 degrees. If you extend this, you will get point C. Okay, so now semicircle O dash at point with point C and with point C as center, O dash C as radius, draw one circle, semicircle, that meets the point. That circle will be traveling through the A point and it will end at D point. This D point is nothing but, this is the point, if you extend the ending point of O dash. If you extend the ending point of O dash, there you will get, if you extend this O dash, I naught value, from I naught value, the end of I naught value is extended parallel to the horizontal line OX. Okay, at that point you will find, if you bisect the O dash A line, you will find C. So C as center, O dash C as radius. If you draw one circle, it will be touching A point and it will stop at D. Okay, so this line ending is B. Okay, so it is called the locus of the current vector for all load conditions from no load to short circuit. Okay, so now AF, find out the value of AF. Actually, AF is 28,440 watts. You found, calculated that. See here, this is the AF, power taken, 28,440 watts. So if you convert this into centimeters, it becomes 81 centimeters. Sorry, 8.1 centimeters, not 81, 8.1 centimeters. So the power scale becomes 28,440 divided by 8.1, you will get 3,510 watts. Okay, see here the calculations. See, AF is 8.1 centimeters. So now the power scale becomes 28,440 divided by 8.1, 3,510 watts. So full load motor output will be equal to, they have given 14,900 watts. So according to the above calculation, if you do like this, 14,900 watts, the intercept will be between the semicircle and the output line. So if you do like this, 3,510 divided by 3,509, you will get 4.25 centimeters. So at O dash A line, this is the O dash A line. It is 4.25 centimeters. So for locating the full load point P, BA will be extended. BA will be extended.